Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, class.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine.
Okay. Are you ready to learn English today?
Yes.
Yes, I'm ready.
Very good. So there are 25 students are joining the class today. Yeah, it means there are still 15 students are missing. Yeah. Masih ada 15 siswa berarti yang belum gabung ya.
Right. Yes.
So hopefully later on they will join us. Okay, so we are not going to start the topic for this semester, but you know, this is the beginning of our class, so we're going to start with the, what we call matrikulasi, yeah. So let's make it similar for everyone, yeah. You understand? Do you speak English? Can you understand my English?
Yes.
Bisa dipahami, bisa dimengerti?
Yes.
Yeah, but before we start, I'd like to introduce myself. Yeah, before we start, I'd like to introduce myself. I am Mr. Ahmad Nasihin. Yeah. And I am an English teacher, so we will be studying English for English peminatan. Yeah, some of you have known me or met me before. Yeah, especially for those who live in Tanjung Balai or somewhere around that area. Yeah, maybe we met before. Yeah, I was one of the teachers who interviewed you. Paham? Jadi pahami? Ya, jadi saya sudah pernah sebenarnya berkunjung. Ya, beberapa siswa, beberapa kalian mungkin sudah ketemu dengan saya sebelumnya. Terutama yang di Tanjung Balai dan sekitarnya Asahan. Ya. Ya. So, anything else you want to ask me before we start the lesson? Ada yang ingin bertanya? So names mentioned already. I introduced my name already. And then Miss Teacher, what else? What would you like to ask something?
Eba.
Nothing.
Nothing. Eba. Okay, that's enough, yeah? Sudah cukup, ya?
Cukup.
Okay, English peminatan. So we're gonna study English peminatan. Okay? Right, so... Yeah, saya yakin, I believe everyone has a different English. Yeah, because you are from various schools. Saya yakin ini bahasa Inggrisnya beda-beda karena kalian sendiri berasal dari sekolah yang beragam ya. Ada yang kemampuan di sekolah ini bagus, ada mungkin agak kurang. So, untuk menyamakan ya standarnya kemampuannya, kita akan memulai dengan matrikulasi dengan topik adverb. So does everybody knows what adverb is? Do you know what is whatever adverb is?
Kata kerja.
Kata apa?
Kata kerja.
Not verb. I say adverb. Adverb. Adverb.
Oh. Verb. Kata benda.
Kata apa itu, ayo?
Bukan kata kerja,
itu kata apa?
Kata
shift. Kata keterangan.
Kata keterangan, that is correct. Ya, yeah. So adverb is kata keterangan. Kalau kata kerja apa?
Tangan.
Verb.
Verb. Right. Kalau kata sifat?
Adjective.
Kalau kata benda?
Noun.
Yeah, good. Yeah, kata benda is noun. So let's repeat once again. Kata benda bahasa Inggrisnya apa?
Noun.
Noun.
Okay. Kata kerja. Kata kerja.
Verb.
Kata keterangan.
Adverb.
Kata sifat.
Adjective.
Kata depan.
Kata depan.
Preposition.
Preposition, correct. Yeah, preposition. Yeah, that's correct. Apa lagi? Kata seru. Kata seru.
Ikonaren.
kata seru. Okay. Interjection. Okay. Ya, kata seru interject. Interjection. Jadi kata itu speech is divided into 8 ya. Kata itu sebenarnya dalam bahasa Inggris dibagi menjadi 8 ya. There are 8 ya. Speech is divided into 8 parts ya. Jadi dibagi 8 itu kata dalam bahasa Inggris itu. Adverb, verb, noun, adjective, preposition, interjection. Ya, ada 8 pokoknya itu ya. Ya, okay. So now we are going to study about adverb today. Yeah, let's start.
Okay.
I'd like to share my slide here. So here is the slide. Ya, yeah, feel free to ask question. Ya, silakan tanya nanti kalau belum paham or it's too fast, please ask. Ya, yeah, so adverbs. Ya, yeah. This is our topic and next slide the objective of learning this topic. Tujuannya belajar adverb ini apa? To identify the social function and the language structure of adverb. Ya, yeah, fungsinya apa sih adverb ini? Terus struktur kalimatnya bagaimana sih adverb ini? That is the first objective or the first purpose, tujuan untuk belajar adverb ini. Jadi kalian bisa mengidentifikasi fungsinya adverb ini apa dan bagaimana struktur kalimatnya. So to differentiate the forms of between adverbs and adjectives. And the adverb and adjective is quite similar, sangat mirip ya. Jadi dengan belajar ini kalian nanti bisa membedakan bentuk daripada adjective dan bentuk daripada adverb. Okay, and then the last purpose, tujuan yang terakhir adalah yeah, you will be able to construct a complete sentence or correct sentence using adverb. Jadi nanti di akhir kalian harus bisa membuat satu kalimat lengkap dan benar dengan menggunakan adverbs. Hopefully. Do you think you can do that? Azril, can you do that later? Do you believe or do you think you can do that later? Aril, oh Aril, not Azril, Aril. Do you think you can do that, Aril, in the end of the class?
Yes.
Insyaallah ya, Aril ya. Okay, right. So this is the learning objective or atau tujuan pembelajarannya. Okay. So now, before we start the topic, I'd like to test you. Nah, sebelum kita mulai nih, ya, Bapak ingin nyoba kalian ini bagaimana kemampuan. How do you think about these sentences? Coba kalian jawab, nggak usah ngomong ya. Ditulis aja. Ditulis dulu di kertas kalian, dijawab di situ selama 1 menit saja. Ada so there are 4 questions here. What you have to do is mudah saja ya. Very simple ya, mudah saja. Kalian tentukan yang kosong itu, as itu ada 2 pilihannya. Ya, ada 2 pilihan yang dalam kurung in the bracket ya, itu yang kalian harus kalian pilih untuk mengisi yang kosong. Fill in the blank with the 2 options provided in the bracket. Okay, we're going to start ya 30 second ya. 30 second I think it's enough to fill in this blank. Untuk mengisi, fill in this blank in 30 second from now. Let's start. I'm counting. 1 2 3 4 Sudah tahu kan caranya? Apa yang harus dikerjakan? Mengisi yang kosong dengan 2 kata yang disediakan di setiap kalimat yang ada dalam kurung. So you gotta fill in the blank with the 2 options divided in the bracket.
See, apply the can Metavolley, maybe.
So I'm going to help you. She cooks blah 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 blah. The option is terrible and terribly. And number 2, he is a blah 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 cook. The option is terrible and terribly. Kemudian number 3, the music was blah blah blah, and the option is beautiful and beautifully. And 14, she plays the piano, and then blah blah blah, beautiful and beautifully. Uh, Alright, done? Ready?
No,
we are ready.
Okay, so let's do it. Let's answer. Number one, who will answer number one?
Sarah.
Who will try? Who will try to answer number one?
Terabile.
Mention, please mention your name. Yeah, please mention your name.
Rivaldi, Pak. Rivaldi.
Okay, Rivaldi, please.
Hi.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Ya.
Perkenalkan nama saya Rivaldi. Perkenalkan nama saya Rivaldi dari kelas 10 Galileo.
Oke. Okay. Rivaldi. Galileo. Right.
Jawaban yang tepat adalah she cooks terribly.
She cooks terribly. Oke. Okay. Terrible or terribly?
Terribly.
Terribly. Alright, so Rivaldi say she cooks terribly. Yes or no?
Yes.
Is it the answer or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, she cooks terribly. That is correct. Dia memasak terribly. Apa artinya terribly itu?
Buruk.
Buruk. Ya, nggak bagus lah masaknya. Masaknya nggak. Oh, dia nggak bisa masak artinya ya. She cooks terribly. It means she cannot cook. Ya. Jadi dia masak dengan jelek. Ya, buruk. Okay, very good, Rivaldi. Thank you. And then number two. Who will answer number two? Akbar. Ya, Akbar. Akbar Soleh. Ya. Okay, wait. Okay, before we start,
Akbar Soleh dari kelompok.
Akbar, can you hold for a second, Akbar? Bisa tahan sebentar, Akbar. Akbar, tahan sebentar ya. Nah, ini kan kita belajar Inggris. We are learning English. Yeah, we are learning English. So, ayo kita mulai. Let's start speaking English from the beginning. Yo. When you introduce yourself, please speak in English. Can you introduce yourself in English? Bisa nggak kira-kira memperkenalkan diri dengan bahasa Inggris?
English, insya Allah bisa.
From class Mandel.
Okay.
Ya, mungkin caranya begini ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello guys. Hello everyone. Oh, hello sir. My name is Akbar Soleh. I am from Mandel class or I'm from Galileo class. Okay, now, and I come from Labuhan Batu, for example. Gitu ya. Jadi kita mulai sedikit-sedikit berbahasa Inggris. Ya, okay, Akbar, please repeat once again.
He is a treble cook.
He is a?
Treble cook.
Terrible, yeah. He is a terrible cook. Terrible. Yeah, terrible. Yeah, can you repeat once again, Akbar?
Can I say it again?
Akbar, can you repeat once again? Akbar, please repeat once again. He is a terrible cook.
Apa, Pak?
Coba diulangi lagi. Coba Akbar diulangi lagi. Coba.
He is a terrible cook.
Ya, okay. He is a terrible cook. Ya, jangan pakai ini ya, apa namanya logat Medan ya, Inggris Batak. He is terrible cook. Ya. He is terrible cook. Okay, very good, Akbar. Thank you. And then number 13, Ariel. Okay, number 3, Ariel. Ya.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Ariel and I from Einstein class. Langsung jawab aja lah itu harus kasir.
Okay.
The music was beautiful, beautifully.
The music was beautiful or beautifully? Your answer is?
Beautifully.
The music was beautifully. Kamu pilih yang beautifully atau beautiful?
Beautifully.
Beautifully. Okay, what do you think, guys? What do you think? Is it correct or incorrect? Correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
Okay, who say incorrect?
I'm sorry, Rivaldi.
Rivaldi say incorrect. Who say correct? Yo, siapa yang bilang betul?
Iya,
oke. Ya, coba yang ada yang mau pendapat lain coba.
I'm sure.
Ya, yeah, oke, okay, please.
Iya.
Yeah. Oke. Okay. The answer of the answer of number 13 is the music was beautiful.
The music was beautiful. Okay, then we have two options here. We have two answers here. So which one is the best? Which one is correct? So I think the correct answer is the music was beautiful. Yeah, the music is beautiful. Kalau kamu bilang, Ariel, misalkan my mother is beautiful or my mother is beautifully. Kalau oh, oke okay. Ya kalau misalkan kalian mau jawab rumahnya bagus, the house is beautiful or the house is beautifully,
the house
beautifully
of... the house is beautiful. Oke okay. You are beautiful or you are beautifully
beautiful.
Karena ada lagunya itu, you are beautiful ya. You are beautiful. So you are beautiful, not you are beautifully. So the music was beautiful, not the music was beautifully. Understand? Okay, next. Number four. The last. Number four. Who will answer number four? Bukan namanya ya. Please mention your name, Rival. Okay, Rival Mugas. Yes.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Hello everyone, my name is Rival Mugas Madani. I'm from an exchange class. I am come from Tebing Tinggi Town.
Okay, I the come from Tebing Tinggi. Okay.
The answer of 14 was she plays the piano beautifully.
Okay, she plays the piano beautifully. Yes or no? Correct or incorrect?
Correct.
Yeah, that is correct. Yeah, okay. Nah, kalau kalian lihat dari empat soal ini, apakah semuanya adverb? Yang mana kira-kira adverb? Nomor satu. Nomor satu. Yang mana adverb? Which is adverb?
Terribly
is adverb. Okay. And then terrible.
Terrible.
Apa ini terrible? Adverb atau apa?
Verb.
Adverb.
Terriblenya adverb. Kalau terriblenya saja?
Adjective.
Adjective. That is correct. Yeah. Terrible is adjective and terribly is adverb. Okay. Number 2 or 12. Yang mana yang adverb? Which is adverb? Sama ya, terribly. Ya, kemudian number 13. Number 13, which is adverb?
Beautifully.
Beautifully. Beautifully is adverb. Kalau beautiful saja?
Adjective.
Adjective. Correct. Ya. Kalau number 14, which is adverb?
Beautifully.
Beautifully and beautiful. Nah, kira-kira ada yang bisa menyimpulkan nggak sih? Kalau dari sekian empat soal ini, kira-kira apa yang bisa kalian tarik di situ, yang bisa kalian bisa bahasa Indonesia? Oke, okay, you can speak in bahasa Indonesia. Kira-kira apa ini yang ada di pikiran kalian? What is in your mind about these three or four questions?
Quickly.
Nah, silahkan. Ada yang pengen ngobrol, pengen ngomong nggak? Yang dari empat soal ini yang kalian amati ini kira-kira apa sih ini? Apa yang bisa kalian dapatkan? What can you learn here?
masa itu adverb.
Krisnawati, you want to say something? You raise your hand or what? Krisnawati tadi tuh angkat tangan. Coba kira-kira Krisnawati apa ini? Apa yang bisa ditarik di sini?
Menurut saya sir, apa namanya? Adverb itu kata yang kayak sudah kata kerjanya gitu.
Nah, oke. Okay.
Bisa sebenarnya kurang paham gitu, sir.
Ah, kurang paham. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, no problem. Ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Ada lagi? Tidak. Ada lagi? Thank you, Krisnawati. Ada lagi coba?
Ada. Thank you.
Oke. Okay. Siapa tadi? Ada yang ngomong? Ada yang mau tadi?
Mensel Aura, sir.
Oke, okay, silakan Aura. Aura Lut, Aura Lutia, oke.
Okay. Menurut saya, sir, okay. Kalau adverb itu di dalam satu kalimatnya itu rumusnya subjek, verb, terus dimasukin adverbnya. Okay. Kalau objektif di kalimatnya itu rumusnya itu subjek, to be, terus masukin adjektifnya, sir.
Ah, oke, okay. Very good. Ya, yeah, that is very good. Ya, yeah. Thank you Aura Lutia. Nah, ini dari Aura Lutia, kalau dia mau mengidentifikasi adverb itu, kata dia, kata si Lutia tadi, ada subjek, kemudian diikuti verb, setelah verb itu barulah adverb, bukan adjective yang masuk. Gitu kan Lutia ya? Kalau dia misalkan subjek, kemudian di situ ada to be, adverb di situ nggak bisa masuk. Tapi yang bisa masuk di situ adalah adjective. Ya, yeah, very good. Ya, yeah, very good. Ya, yeah, thank you, Lutia. Ada lagi yang lain?
Yes, sir.
Siapa itu? Siapa yang lagi? Ada lagi tadi? Siapa? Tuh. Ada lagi? Anyone else? Ada yang mau ngomong lagi? Yes, who's that? Ya, silakan. Silakan. Sebutkan namanya ya. To introduce your name. Ya, mention your name. Silakan sebutkan namanya in English. In English.
Hello, sir. My name Muhammad Imam Maulana Purba. I'm from Indonesia.
Oke, okay, Imam, ya.
Menurut saya, sir, kalau adverb itu kata keterangan yang sudah kita lakukan.
Gimana?
Kalau adverb itu, sir, keterangan yang sudah kita lakukan gitu, sir.
Oh, keterangan yang sudah kita lakukan, oke. Okay. Ada lagi? Ya. Ya, oke, okay, thank you. Ya, action, dia menerangkan action yang kita lakukan, oke. Okay. Action yang kita apa namanya dia memberikan keterangan apa yang kita lakukan. That's correct ya. Yeah. Ya, yeah, oke, okay. Saya kira cukup ya. Kalau dari dua pendapat itu bisa ditarik kesimpulan. Satu dari Lutfiah tadi ya, subjek kalau misalkan ada adverb itu biasanya formasi kalimatnya atau bentuk kalimatnya itu ada apa?
Subjek.
Kemudian
adverb.
Masuklah dia and
adverb.
Kalau adjective
subject
ada to be, masuklah dia ke apa namanya adjective. Nah, kalian tidak bisa bilang gini misalkan my sister is beautifully. Can you say that or not?
Nah,
kenapa enggak bisa? Kenapa enggak bisa? Kenapa nggak bisa? Why?
Karena
nggak ada perbnya sir.
Karena tidak ada because yeah we don't find verb there, but the sentence is using to be. Very good. Yeah. Okay, sebenarnya ada lagi nih yang bisa kalian di sini. Kalau apa namanya adverb itu coba lihat adverbnya ini. Apa bedanya adverb sama adjective dari kalimatnya?
Ditambahin ly sama
akhirnya ditambahin.
Ya, biasanya kan itu adverb itu diambil it's taken from ya dibentuk dari jadi apa namanya adverb itu dibentuk dari apa? Adjective sebenarnya ya. Ada beberapa ya. So and then so untuk merubahnya menjadi adverb, we just add L and Y. But again, you have to remember not all, yeah, but most, yeah, many. Enggak semuanya ya, enggak semuanya. Ya, harus hati-hati nih, enggak semuanya. Ya, tapi ada banyak di situ dengan penambahan L then L LY, Lee, ya. Terrible become terribly, beautiful become beautifully. Coba apa lagi yang adjective kemudian adverb? Coba.
Good.
Good become,
jadi well.
Good become well. Well. Good become well. Nah, di situ nambah LY enggak?
No, sir.
Nah, that's correct. Ya, enggak semuanya kan saya bilang tadi. Not all of the adjective can be formed become adverb by adding ly. Not all, but many of them. Ya, tapi ada banyak. Ya. Nah, kayak misalkan seperti good, ya nggak bisa menjadi goodly. No, you cannot say goodly, but you can say, but it's changed to be well. Good become well. Coba kasih saya, give me more example. Adjective changed to be adverb by added ly. Coba lagi.
Slow become slowly.
Slowly, very good. Yes. Next. Apa?
Really.
Say again.
Real.
I cannot hear clearly. Can you repeat once again? Slowly. Apa lagi? Careful.
Carefully.
Okay, right. So now we move to the next slide. Yeah, do you understand? Yeah. Jadi sebenarnya adverb itu apa sih? Nah, what is adverb? Do you know what adverb is? Ah, saya ada dijelaskan. So adverbs usually describe verbs. Jadi adverb itu biasanya dia menjelaskan kata kerja. Seperti tadi ya, seperti contoh-contoh sebelumnya tadi, dia menjelaskan kata kerja. Biasanya dia juga mengekspresikan kapan, when, how, kemudian ada where, di mana, kemudian ada why. Nah, tadi why an action is done. Kenapa pekerjaan itu sudah dilaksanakan? Ya, di sini biasanya dia mengekspresikan kapan, bagaimana, di mana, dan mengapa. Ya, maksudnya how dengan cara apa? Dengan rajin. Dia belajar dengan gerak, dengan rajin, dengan giat. Ya. Kapan? Biasanya adverb itu dibagi menjadi beberapa. Ya, ada adverb of time, adverb of place, adverb manner, frequency, purpose, atau reason. Nah, sini kita fokus manner dulu ya. Jadi kita mempelajari yang manner aja dulu di sini ya. Yang sikap atau cara tadi ya. Many adverbs are easy to find because they have the ly ending. Jadi biasanya adverb itu mudah dikenali. Kenapa mudah dikenali? Karena akhirannya yang diakhir dengan ly.
Ly.
For example like quick become
quickly.
Sure become
surely.
Certain become
Certainly.
Ya, tapi ingat, nggak semuanya, ya, nggak semuanya diakhiri dengan ly atau ly, nggak semuanya. Ya, seperti hard itu kerja. He works hard. Okay, I'm gonna give you an example. He works hard. Okay, hard di situ adjective atau adverb?
Adjective. I think
he works. Hard. He studies hard. Hard here as adjective or adverb?
Adverb.
Kenapa disebut adverb?
Karena dia ngasih tahu kalau itu keras.
Kenapa?
Karena diikuti kerja.
Ah, kalian lupa tadi informasi di awal tadi.
Ikuti for.
Susunan katanya, coba susunan kalimatnya dilihat. He.
Ada kata kerja sih.
Subject. And then studies.
Birth.
Kita studies. Oke, karena kan katanya tadi subject ada verb. Verb diikuti berarti dengan adverb, bukan eject.
Adjective.
Nah, jadi adverbnya itu menerangkan bagaimana dia melakukan sesuatu itu. Seperti di sini nih ya, bagaimana dia, how an action is done, where the action is done, why an action is done. Manner berarti how is the action, how an action is done, bagaimana pekerjaan itu dilakukan. Berarti itu manner ya. Manner itu berarti caranya, bagaimana sikapnya, attitude-nya. Bisa dipahami? Can you understand?
Yes, sir.
Tapi nanti kalau nggak paham, nanya ya. Please, ask me question. Feel free to ask question ya, if you don't understand. Okay, next. Nah, ini sudah ya, sudah kita. Nah, ini contohnya yang lain. So, have a look at these pictures. Nah. Kira-kira number one, is it good sentence or not? Yang mana adverb? Can you find adverb here?
Loudly.
Loudly. Betul nggak di sini adverb bukan adjective?
Ya.
Kenapa? Kenapa? Why? Kenapa ini betul?
Karena
sebelumnya
subjek,
jadi loudly ini menerangkan bagaimana dia ngomong gitu loh. How the action is done, bagaimana pekerjaan itu dilakukan, bagaimana apa pekerjaannya di sini ngomong ya kan. Action-nya apa ini? Ngomong.
Yes, sir.
Bagaimana action-nya itu dilakukan? Oh, dengan keras. Misalnya ini di, kalau diterjemahkan ke bahasa Indonesia menjadi he speak loudly, dia bicara dengan keras. Ditambah dengan.
Dengan.
Ya. Okay, now here, look at the picture. Look at the picture. The police is checking the documents carefully. Mana ini action-nya?
Carefully.
Yeah. Coba ini Aisyah Fitria Yolanda, can you read this? Police. Coba diulangi dibaca.
The police is checking the document
carefully. Yang mana ini adverbnya? Which is the adverb, Yolanda?
Carefully.
Yeah, very good. Kenapa di sini dia sebagai adjective adverb coba?
Karena sudah terjadi.
Ah, bukan karena sudah terjadi, tapi karena lihat dari susunan kalimatnya ini. Ada verb, ada subject dan ada
subject verb.
Ada object.
Ada objeknya juga, boleh ditambahkan objek. Nah, kalau ini coba, tadi sudah ya. Coba saya pengen Farah, please Farah read.
Yes.
Please read Farah.
Iya, yes, sir. Apa?
Coba dibaca ini yang terakhir. Ya nih gambar orang baca buku ini.
John studies hard.
John studies hard. Mana ini adverbnya?
Hard, sir.
Hard, okay, very good. Ya, kenapa dia di situ sebagai adverb?
Karena sebelumnya ada verb, sir.
Okay, kalau coba misalkan saya ganti misalkan. The question is hard. Okay, the question is hard. Hard di situ sebagai adjective atau adverb?
Adjective, sir.
Kenapa sebagai adjective? Why is it adjective?
Because there is to be.
Right, because it's before the adjective is to be. Yeah, not verb. Nah, that's right. That's correct. Ya, kita lanjut ya. Nah, di sini sih sebenarnya sudah ya. What is the apa sih bedanya antara adjective dengan adverb itu, bedanya di mana? Nah, di sini ya. Adjective itu dia memberikan gambaran atau menerangkan kata benda. Adjective itu menerangkan kata benda. My mom is beautiful. Siapa yang beautiful?
Orang dulu tahunya.
My mom. Ya, my mom itu kan kata benda, ya, kata benda, ya. Jadi beautiful itu menerangkan kata benda. Ya. Ya, maka dia adjective. Sedangkan adverb itu menerangkan kata kerja. Contohnya, ya, she works or she sings beautifully. She sings beautifully. Beautifully itu menerangkan apa? Menerangkan. Atau misalkan ya, my mom sings beautifully.
Menerangkan sings.
Menerangkan apa ya?
Sing.
Ya, menerangkan pekerjaannya, bukan menerangkan orang. Pekerjaannya yang diterangkan. Bagaimana dia bernyanyi? Oh, dengan bagus.
Dengan.
Ya.
Indah.
Dengan indah. Ya. Nah, adverb juga bisa menerangkan kata kerja. Dia juga bisa menerangkan adjective itu sendiri. Ya. Dan dia juga bisa menerangkan adverb. Ada dua adverb. Dia menerangkan adverb dengan adverb yang lain. Ya, contohnya she is carefully. The adjective careful is describing the noun. She walks carefully. Nah, di sini. Sini adjective dan di sini adalah adverb. The adverb carefully describing the verb walk. Ya, bisa dipahami nih?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Ya?
Bisa, sir.
Oke, di sinilah bedanya antara adjective dengan adverb. Oke, these are the list of adverb. Nah, ini contoh-contohnya nih adverb nih. Yang dari adjective ke adverb, adjective and adverb. Angry, the adverb is Angry. Apa artinya angry?
Marah.
Marah. Anxiously. Apa arti anxious? Khawatir ya, cemas. Bad. Adverbnya apa? Brave. Apa artinya brave?
Berani.
Adverbnya
bravely.
Oke, okay, so, nah ini kan kayaknya terbatas nih ya. Nah, nggak bisa habis ini aja ya. We don't have much time left, ya. Yeah. Ya, jadi harus kita akhiri nih, karena waktu cuma 30 menit. But we haven't finished. Ya, kita belum selesai ya. Tetapi kalian, saya ingatkan, coba nanti di internet tuh banyak tuh. Kalian cari, buat list seperti ini ya. Ya, ini PR ya. Coba dicari, kalian buat ini adjective, ini adverb, ini adjective-nya. Buat daftar katanya seperti itu. Dan dihafal gitu ya. Oke?
Okay?
Ya, ini okay, contohnya
sir.
Ya.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Nah. Ingat, tidak semua kata yang diakhiri dengan ly atau ly itu adalah adverb. Dia juga kadang menjadi adjective. Ya, contohnya seperti ini. Sam was feeling very lonely. Lonely is diakhiri dengan ly, tapi lonely di sini bukan adverb. Kesepian, ya, sangat kesepian artinya lonely ini. Kenapa di sini tidak adverb? Sam was feeling very lonely. Yang jadi adverb bukan di sininya, ya, bukan ininya yang jadi adverbnya. Tapi di sini adalah adjective. Contohnya yang lainnya lagi, she was wearing a lovely dress. Lovely, lovely. Di sini akhiri oleh ly juga, tapi lovely di sini bukan adverb, tapi adjective. Cantik ya. It was a very lively party. Ya, ini sangat hidup ya. Ini juga bukan adverb, tapi adjective. Nah, di situ. Ini macam-macam adjective, adverb, ada adverb manner, ada place, ada time, frequency, purpose, and then frequency. Yang tadi kita pelajari adalah adverb manner. Ini, ya, dia menerangkan cara bagaimana pekerjaan itu dilakukan ya. Ya, contohnya seperti ini. Ah, sebenarnya kita punya apa namanya?
Okay.
Exercise lagi nih ya. Coba satu aja dijawab coba. Yang ini coba. Ini contohnya Tom is slow. He walks slowly. Nah, nomor 2 coba. Can you answer number 2 please?
Who is a careful girl?
She climbed up the ladder carefully.
Dia manjat tangga itu dengan hati-hati. Yang ini number 3.
It barks angrily.
It barks angrily. Okay, number 4. He is an excellent actor. Okay, number 5. They learn English easily. They think English is an easy language. Yeah. Number 6.
Max is a singer. He sings well. Very good. Okay, that is an example.
Itu adalah contoh contoh-contohnya latihan-latihannya. Tapi kalian juga bisa mempelajari di rumah ya sambil cari-cari exercise. So we still have a lot of exercises here, but unfortunately we don't have enough time. So for example, like this is the answer key. And then here is another exercises, but unfortunately we cannot do it. So thank you. So that is the end of our slide and the end of our class today. Thank you class for joining. I hope you understand. You understand?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Okay. Later on,
you gotta check the Schoology. Okay, please check Schoology and there will be some tasks for you for exercises. Okay, again, thank you very much for joining our class today. And we close our session. Alhamdulillah. And have a nice day. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.
Bonare.
Okay, please. Please. Why is it not?